Well, it's the winter of 2021. There's 5 inches of snow on the ground and the temperature's below freezing. The COVID-19 pandemic is still raging and I haven't yet got my vaccination. I'm bored to death and I'm cooped up. What's an old firecrafter to do in this kind of situation?
I've been wanting to mathematically quantify and describe the process of fire by friction for a really long time now. It's cold outside and there's several inches of snow on the ground, and I decided that I would finally sit down, put pen to paper, and give it a try. I had a breakthrough a few weeks ago when I came across a YouTube video and a related article that were aimed at calculating friction in a disc brake system. Well, the disc brake problem required a two-dimensional integration in planar polar coordinates. But for the fire by friction problem, I had to modify that analysis and expand it into spherical coordinates. And once I made that conversion, I realized I had all the pieces of the puzzle in place, and the solution came together pretty quickly after that. What I ultimately was able to calculate was a formula for the expected minimum time required for initial ember ignition under a set of favorable assumed circumstances. And I guess it goes without saying that my focus has been on the bow drill. Well, despite all the mathematical gymnastics I went through, the solution that I finally came up with was actually quite simple, pretty compact, and in many ways it was pretty intuitive. All the variables that you would ordinarily expect are in there. If you press down on the spindle harder, you'll make a faster ember. If you bow faster, you'll make a faster ember, etc. The solution was pretty satisfying in that regard. Interestingly enough, I was also able to show that the geometric shape of the spindle actually matters. In fact, spindles that are carved to have a nearly hemispherical profile actually can cause ember ignition up to 15% faster than with blunt-tipped spindles. This was a discovery that I made that was really unexpected and quite exciting. It's a purely geometric effect that I discovered while I was just letting the math take me where it naturally wanted to go. It's just the process of scientific discovery. Well, I wrote it all down in an article that I'm calling The Physics of Fire by Friction, and I put a link to this article down in the description of the video below. I've also put a link to a scanned copy of my handwritten notes in case you're interested in digging a little deeper. I'm a big believer in the peer review process of authenticating scientific discovery, and so I'm hoping you're going to download my article, read it, and give it some scrutiny. Please let me know if you find any mistakes and give me a chance to fix them. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask them. I'll try to answer them. And if you find any sections that need some clarification or I can write in a simpler way, let me know and I'll make some edits. It's been a fun little project for the past 6 weeks or so, but I'm really getting tired of the cold weather. I'm looking forward to warming up in the spring and going out and sit beside the fire pit in my backyard and smelling the smoke and listening to the firewood crackle. Till then, be safe. I'll see you again really soon. Bye-bye.